Namaste everyone, welcome back to our channel, The GAN Center. I'm Richa Shakya and I'll be helping you to learn basic English grammar. We've been discussing about the different parts of speech, and in the previous video, we learned about the nouns, its different types, and the various rules to be followed while using them. Today's lesson is all about pronouns. So what is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word that replaces a noun or takes place of a noun in a sentence. Pronouns are used to avoid repeating the same nouns over and over again. For example, Nima works at the hospital. Nima goes to work every day. Nima loves taking care of her patients. The above sentences sound very repetitive, as we are repeating the same noun, Nima, over and over again. So, instead of repeating the noun Nima, we can use she in its place, which makes the sentence more natural. Like, Nima works at the hospital. She goes to work every day. She loves taking care of her patients. Now, let us discuss about the different types of pronouns. Basically, pronouns are divided into following categories: personal pronoun, reflective and intensive pronoun, indefinite pronoun, and interrogative pronoun. Let's begin with personal pronouns. The pronouns that are used as a substitute for a person's name are called personal pronouns. These can further be divided into three types. They are subjective pronouns, objective pronouns, and possessive pronouns. Subjective pronouns. The pronouns that act as subject in the sentence are called subjective pronouns. For example, they went to the market. Here, they acts as a subject of the sentence, so it is a subjective pronoun. Similarly, in the sentence, he does not want to work. He is also a subjective pronoun. Other examples of subjective pronouns are I, you, she, it, we, etc. Objective pronouns. The pronouns that act as an object in the sentence is called objective pronouns. For example, please don't talk to me, or don't look at them. The words me and them are acting as objects, so they are objective pronouns. Few examples of objective pronouns are her, him, us, it, them, etc. Possessive pronouns. The pronouns that show possession or ownership are called possessive pronouns. For example, this is our house. In this sentence, our is the possessive pronoun, or that is my book. Here, my is also a possessive pronoun. Other possessive pronouns are you, his, her, their, its, etc. One of the most important and common mistakes that we make while using the possessive pronouns like ours, yours, hers, its, theirs, etc. is that we put apostrophe before the S. There should be no apostrophe before S in these cases. Let us now move on towards the reflexive pronouns and intensive pronouns. Reflexive pronouns. These are the pronouns like myself, himself, herself, yourself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, and themselves. These enlisted pronouns are the only reflexive pronouns in English grammar. They are called reflexive pronouns because they reflect back to the subject of the sentence. Reflexive pronouns are used when the subject as well as the object of the sentence is same. For example, Nirjala blamed herself for her poor health. Who did she blame? She blamed herself. In this sentence, both subject and object are same. So, in order to show this relationship, we use herself, which is a reflexive pronoun. The use of words like ourselves, themselves, and theirselves is prohibited because these words do not exist in English grammar. Intensive pronouns. Intensive pronouns look same as reflexive pronouns, but their purpose is to intensify or add emphasis to the nouns. For example, I built the castle by myself. Here, myself gives the emphasis to the noun, stating that I built the castle personally. Similarly, in the sentence, she did the work herself. The word herself is intensive pronoun. Okay, so let's now move on towards indefinite pronoun. These are the words like everybody, someone, anything, something, neither, or either. They do not refer to any particular person or particular thing, so they are called indefinite pronouns. For example, everybody was late to work because of traffic jam. And no one knows the answer to the question. In the above sentences, everybody and no one are indefinite pronouns. The indefinite pronouns act as the subject of the sentence, and they usually take a singular verb. Now let's talk about the final category of pronouns, the interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns are question words like who, whom, whose, what, and which. For example, what do you want to eat for lunch? Here, what is the interrogative pronoun that is used when we have many options. Whereas if we have only a few options, we use which. Like, which finger did you break? Another example could be, who went to the party? Here, who is asking question? Hence, it is an interrogative pronoun. So, in today's lesson, we learned about the different types of pronouns and the rules to be followed to avoid making mistakes while using them. In the next video, we'll be discussing about the verbs. Thank you everyone for keeping up with us. And thank you IME Pay for supporting our motive. If you liked our video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel, The GAN Center. Thank you. Bye-bye.